Okay, so welcome to model 12, and on this model 12, I'll be showing you how to apply how to load your structure and how to apply wind load to your structure. Now, before you must apply wind load to your structure, you must first of all apply what they call or load your structure. And before you must apply wind load to your structure, a wind load should be applied to any structure that is at least that the height is up to 10 meters and above. So once your building is below 10 meters, you don't have to apply wind load. But once your building is up to 10 meters and above, you at that point, wind will have to affect that building. So you have to apply wind load. So on this model 12, I'll be showing you how to apply wind load and also how to load your structure. Okay, so right now, let's now move in now to know how to load our structure. So how to load your structure right now, you click on this place that says concrete design first. And this place, you will begin to see your concrete section designs and all that. But right now, to now begin to load your structure, click on the place that says analysis here, and then click on this place that says building analysis. I'll click on this place now and then wait for it to load. Now, whenever I click on that analysis and then building analysis, it must save by its own, because right now it is trying to enter into a new phase from the modeling stage down to the building analysis and design stage. So it must try to save what you have done on the model stage. Okay, so right, but basically we are not entering into the design stage right now. We are just trying to load the structure, and it is on that tab that we find our loading option to apply wind load and also to load the structure. Okay, so in this model, as I repeat again why it is saving, I said you will learn how to load your structure and also how to apply wind load to a structure. And I have told you already that before you must apply your wind load to a structure, that structure must be more than 10 meters and above. As you can see that this one right now on this tree at this level of 9 story, it is 29.38 meters. So at this level or at this height, there is tendency that wind load will affect the structure. So if you don't apply wind load on this structure, you will see that this structure will fail, because wind load will have effect on it and it will cause collapse. But if you apply wind load of that terrain, or the terrain where this building is to be sited, and we apply the wind load effect on this building, you will see that even if when the wind blows, it will not have effect on the structure. But the wind, which I'm saying, is not like it is not like, let me say, an adverse weather condition, just like, let me say, hurricane. If it is a hurricane, you know, hurricane force everything that is being found at its presence. But this is just in a manual bad adverse condition, like normal wind and not hurricane wind. Okay, or in a very light storm, it will not affect the structure. But if it is a hurricane, I will tell you that the structure will be by the grace of God to stand. Okay, so right now, because hurricane is like an earthquake, although they can design against earthquake, but right now they cannot design against hurricane, because hurricane comes with a stumbling wind. So it's very hard to design against hurricane. Okay, so right now we are trying to apply manual wind load, which is normal wind load, to structures. Okay, so before you must apply wind load to your structure, you must first of all apply loading combinations, and that we will click on this place now, which is to load your structure. So to load your structure, you have to click on this place here, and then click on this place that says loading generator. Now on this place, you have to click on this place that says horizontal loading combination. Now if you are applying wind load, click on this place that says horizontal combination and click on this place that says wind loading. Okay, on this place now, we have just checked that we are trying to apply wind load to the structure. Else, if there is no wind load, we will not check this, and we will just click on OK. But since there is wind load on this structure, we will check the wind load, as you can see it here, and then back to this place, and then click on what? OK. Now, on this place now, you will now see all your loading condition now is being shown here. Now, click on this place that says OK here again. And then we have just, what we have just done now is to load the structure, but we have not applied wind load to the structure, because wind load comes with the wind speed and also how the weather or the terrain of that area where the where the building is to be sited is. Okay, so right now apply wind load to our structure. You can now click on this that says wind and storey loads. So I'll click on this place now that says wind and storey loads, and then wait for it to show the wind load dialog box. Okay, so right now I'll wait for it to now show my wind load dialog box, which will take less than 1 minute to show. So let's just hold on for it to pop up just now. Okay, so right now on this plate now that says storey parameters and load, as you can see there, you can now see this plate that says wind load calculator. Click on this plate that says wind load calculator, and then you will see it now showing the wind load parameter dialog box. Okay, so on this plate now that says wind load parameters dialog box, the first thing that we have there is parameters. You can see there now on these parameters that I can see here, you are seeing the first area here, which is the input sheet that says basic wind properties. Now under this basic wind properties, it is telling you basic wind speed. This basic wind speed simply means what is the wind speed of the area or the terrain where your building is to be sited. Now, if this is to be right now, is to be sited in, let me say, New York. New York now, I will have to go and know the wind load or the average wind speed around New York or around the city of New York or around the place where this building is to be sited. So you can get that value in Google, or you can get the value of the average wind speed from your weather scientist. Okay, so right now, I will have to put my own wind speed here as 45, or let me say 44.5 as my as the wind speed for this A-story building. Let me say that this building is to be sited in, let me say, Jakarta. Okay, so I'll just put the wind speed of that city, Jakarta. Okay, so right now I will now go to this place here that says minimum wind pressure. Minimum wind pressure, you can leave it as default as it is, which simply means the lowest wind, like a normal wind, like a normal temperature. So you can just leave it as 0.65. Okay, but the main one is to put this one here. Now this place that says primary wind angle, I always advise leave this angle as zero, because this angle simply means if you put any value in this primary wind angle, that means that you know where the wind is coming from, and knowing that nobody knows where the wind comes or blows and where it goes, so leave the value as zero, because that it can come from any angle to hit the structure. So leave it as zero, and then come to this place now that says terrain and surrounding parameters. Now this HO, you can see this HO here, put your eye on this diagram here. HO, this is length as this one here that says building. This is a building that you are designing for. So in this case, this is our A-story building, and you can see that this place now have different obstacles. As you can see, obstruction, which is obstacle. So HO simply means the height of any obstacle before your building. So what I mean by obstacle is that if you have a tree or flowers around the terrain or the site where you're meant to build your A-story, these are A-story building right now, it saying that what is the height of that tree. Or if you have, let me say, like a city in New York, you know New York have high-rise buildings like 24-story, 30-story, 80-stories. So if you are to build your A-story building around that kind of place, you will see that the wind speed of that place will be very, very minimal, because there are already existing tall buildings around that area. So it will not have much effect on your own building, because there are already giant buildings around it. So what this place is saying, that what is the height of those obstruction or those buildings or those trees around your building, around the place where you're about to site that your building. So in this case right now, I'll just say the highest, since my own highest is 27.9 something meters, so I can say that the highest height there is, let me say, 37 meters. Okay, 37 meters is the highest building or the highest obstacle height around that place, or the building around that place. Okay, so right now I will now say what is the distance. Now what is the distance of that obstacle to your own building? Now if it is a tree, what is the distance of that tree to the point where you're meant to site your building? If it is a neighbor's house, or let me say a neighbor's shop or building that have up to high-rise, or let me say 10-story building, what is the distance of that your neighbor's house to your very point where you want to start building your own mansion? Okay, so right now I'll just I can just say and 15 or leave it as default as 10. But I always advise you just leave it as default as 10 because you don't know exactly the distance of that obstacle to your building. So leave it as default as 10. And then on this place that says delta x, which simply means mean sea level, I'll say that leave this place at which is the site altitude or mean sea level, leave it as 100 because you don't know the mean sea level around that area and it's very hard to measure mean sea level to your land. So leave it as default. And this also, which is the distance of sea upwind, leave it as default. Now this place that says city town, site type, and you can see this place that say town and then country. I see that town simply means just as we use New York as an instance. New York is like a town because hardly you find any kind of bushy environment around that place. All the place are being developed and you will see high-rise buildings. So in that place, that is a town. But if you're to build this place now in Africa, let me say in Africa, like Nigeria or Ghana, or you can see that those places are still developing countries, and most times you begin to find vegetations like bush and all that place that is not well developed, and you still have vegetations in some areas because of lack of finances. So in that kind of place right now, you can see that that you have large mass of, let me say, vegetations. So you can choose. So in that case right now, there'll be a high wind there because your own structure is the highest one and the resting around that place are just green trees, and they're not even too tall to be able to withstand wind load for your building. Okay. So if you're to build on this kind of area, know that you are going to have a very high massive of wind pressure of this 44.5 hitting your structure. But if I choose town right now, since town is like a New York, or let me say a developed city, and there are tall buildings around the places, so it will be able to break the wind load before it will not hit on my own structure. Okay, that's fine. So right now I'll choose town on this place. So, but I have just shown you how to choose. Okay, so right now on this place that says building type, you can see this place that says category. Click on that place, you will see the building type right now. So this A story building is a concrete building and not a steel building. So right now I'll just go here right now, and then you will see different options here. Weathered steel, which is not, you can see bolted steel, and I'll see unclad frame, which is not. So we are designing for a frame building with structural walls, yes, which is structural walls around lift, which is yes, and then staircase with additional masonry. So this is what describes a reinforced concrete structure. So this is one that describes a reinforced concrete structure. So I'll go here right now and then click here and then say okay, that's fine. So right now with this, right now we have just finished loading our wind load. You can also choose your wind load code here. You can see different kind of load here, but since we're using BS code, I'll just leave it as BS6399, which is part 2, I'll leave it at that place and then click on the place that says apply. So we did apply now, and then click on okay. So by clicking on okay now, automatically right now we have applied that wind load to this structure. So I'll now click on this place that says what, close, and then click on what, save. So by clicking on save right now, you will see that on this level, I have shown you guys how to load your structure and also how to apply your wind load to your structure. So this is how to apply wind load to your structure. Now, in the whole summary, you have told you guys, you have to apply wind load to any structure that is above 10 meters. So once your building is up to 10 meters and above, you have to apply wind load, else don't apply wind load to that structure. Okay, because wind load affects any structure that is around for or that is at the level of 10 meters and above. Okay, so right now we have applied wind load on this structure because this structure alone is an eight-story building having a basement and also a concrete roof, and the height of it for now is already 29.38 meters. So at this point, you can see that it is already three times the height at which a wind load is to affect a structure, which is at 10 meters, and this is already at 29.38 meters. Okay, so you cannot see how to apply wind load to your structures. Okay, so right now we are now moving into the next model, which is model 13, and I will show you guys how to now put in your wall load onto your structure, like how to apply wall load to your beams, and you can see that this is purely a frame structure. As you can see that it's a frame structure, so we are meant now to, these beams are meant to carry wall loads around these places. So we are to, I'm going to show you how to apply wall loads to this to your buildings. Okay, so right now we are done with this model 11 and we are moving to model 12 for the how to apply wind load. Okay, so right now we'll be moving now to the next phase now. Okay, bye.